Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I have this power supply PS24E. It is from iPhone, made in Japan. It is 24 volt 2 ampere. It is not powering on. Let's check it. When you are testing any device, always use series length to power up. And if you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair it yourself. DC voltage positive, negative, and ground. We don't have any output here. While at input terminal, we have 238 volts. Let's see what is the problem. For troubleshooting, first we will open it. It has 4 screws here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this is covered. Yes, it have some discoloration. Let's open it and never touch any area before testing the voltage on main DC capacitor. DC voltage. Okay, it is discharged. It is safe. Now let's inspect it. We can see we have burning sign here on this capacitor. Wow, this IC is damaged. You can see, and it is using 3842 IC. So this family 3842, 3843, 3844, 3845, these ICs have approximately the same circuit, and this resistor is burned out. This resistor, this capacitor, maybe this capacitor have burning sign from this IC. Initially we find IC and this resistor. Other items are looking some good. Now we will replace this IC. Locate the cut mark. This is index mark, that is pin number 1. First I will touch the solder to all pins so that it is better for thermal conductivity. Yes, the IC is out. Now we will install new IC. Now this IC is in this condition. We can see one pin is separated totally. Yes, this is 3842, and this one is, if you have UC3842 or KA3842, the same. Both numbers are the same. If you have KA3842 or UC3842, the same. You can use any one number. 3842, this is the generic number. Now by checking the cut mark, index mark, aligning pin 1 to pin 1 on the footprint, install this IC here in the board. I will bend one pin here so that it will hold in the board. After soldering, using isopropyl alcohol, technical alcohol, thinner, separate, we will use this IC in the soldering area. Now we will check this capacitor. Why it is in some suspected position. Let's check it. Yes, capacitor. Discharge the capacitor properly before testing, before connecting to multimeter. Red lead to positive and black lead to ground. It is 36.8 microfarad and it is 47, so its value is dropped. We will replace this capacitor because it must be 47 microfarad. If we will install in this condition, it will not hold the charge properly and power supply will go in fluctuation because it will not maintain the voltage on VCC pin. I have this capacitor for 47 micro 50 volt. Discharge it and then check it. Yes, 45.5. It is good because this one it was 36, but this one is good. We can check this rectifier. It is also damaged. Now I will remove this diode. Now I will use 1 and 4001 or 4007. That is good. I will use 1 and 4007 diode in the auxiliary section. Insert the diode by taking care for the polarity. Now we want to check this resistor, that is here. We will open one end, 5.3 ohms. This is connected here and it is going to drive the MOSFET. Yes, it is connected at pin number 6. Then here, then it is reaching to MOSFET. So resistor is good. Might be it is damaged due to this IC, or we need to verify this MOSFET. Now I am installing the capacitor. When you are installing polar capacitor, DC capacitor, take care for the polarity. Never connect in reverse polarity, otherwise the capacitor will damage immediately. If you are searching for the schematic, maybe you will not find the exact circuit diagram. For that purpose, look, check the IC number and go to Google Chrome and search for the data sheet. In the data sheet you will find sample circuit for this IC. It will guide us how this circuit is working. Now let's check it. What is the result now? We can see the supply have some strange sound. And if we check voltage, we have low voltage fluctuation. That means the IC is switching now, but it have something short circuit in the secondary. And we can also monitor at the IC. pin number 5 and pin number 7 pin number 8, we can see the IC have fluctuation. If you want to find the fluctuation, the best way, we can open the output rectifier. That is the easiest solution. This time we have low voltage with fluctuation, that means there is something short circuit. If we have full voltage here, more than the rated value, with fluctuation, that means the feedback network is problematic. But now in millivolt, we have output voltage in millivolt and we have fluctuation, so we need to check the voltage here, and we can also check here on the rectifiers. We can see there is something wrong in the output side. So we need to verify here. Now let's check the output side components. Set multimeter to diode. This diode. This zener diode is damaged. This zener diode is also damaged. Two zener, yes, this here SCR, that is also damaged. Here we have 431A voltage reference, and behind this we have SCR. So SCR is damaged. We have this zener and this zener. Both zeners are short circuit. Let's remove it and then we will check it. Ye zener. Now I am removing the short circuit components. This zener. So ye short circuit hai. Now I am removing the SCR. This SCR is damaged. और ये zener भी यहाँ पे उतार देता हूँ. Now I removed this zener. It is C27, 27 volt zener. Yes, it is short circuit. It is using 2431A in this circuit, 1 and 2. After removing these components, let's power on and check either there is some short circuit present or finished now. DC voltage. Volt. We can see we have 45 volt here. It is now uncontrolled. There is no feedback. If we check voltage at feedback, that means the feedback is reaching here. And if we check here, it have 3.5 volt. That's not good. That means our optocoupler is might be damaged. I think the optocoupler is damaged. We need to replace it. Here is it is using P421 optocoupler. Let's check this optocoupler. It is P421, TLP421. It is similar to PC817. I will use kilo ohm, and here pin number 4 positive, red lead, pin number 3 black lead, this multimeter in resistance mode and this in diode mode. Here it is 1 volt, that means the diode side is good. The collector side, emitter transistor side, it is not giving a resistance. Now I will check this one. Yes, this one is giving resistance. And if I check this one, it is not giving resistance. Now I am connecting PC817 in place of TLP421. Now let's power on. Yes, this time the current is regular, and if we check input side, now it is good condition. We have 1.09 volts and output side, now it is 2.84, that means it is now in conduction state. And if we check output voltage, it is now exactly 24.87 volts and it is regulated. Before this, when this optocoupler was not working, it was not switching to the IC. At that time 45 volts were here. So these were the problems here. This IC bad, VCC capacitor, one resistor, and this protection circuit. I will arrange these components and I will install it. Now this output is available. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, write in the comments. Thanks for watching.